الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، إله الأولين والآخرين، وصلي وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We have reached the ayah of Surah An-Nisa'. Allah has said, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا نَصِيبًا مِنَ الْكِتَابِ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْجِبْتِ وَالطَّاغُوتِ I'm sorry. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ يُزَكُّونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ بَلِ اللَّهُ يُزَكِّي مَن يَشَاءُ وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ فَتِيلًا Ayah number 49 from Surah An-Nisa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, haven't you seen or haven't you seen those the one who يُزَكُّونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ Basically Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't you see those people then who claim themselves as pure or to be pure. Basically they praise in themselves, they give and compliment themselves. They, in a way, when you think about yourself too much, you praise yourself in a way. Say, Rasulullah, haven't you seen those, the people, the one who praise in themselves so much, in a way, look at him. Subhanallah. And purifying or complimenting or praising yourself in Islam is not permissible. We should not. I'm this, I'm that, my family this, my father that, I am an engineer, I'm a doctor, I'm an attorney, I'm a teacher, I'm educated, I know this and this and that. And this for a certain reason, we're going to come to it inshallah. Allah said in the Quran, فَلَا تُزَكُّوا أَنفُسَكُمْ Do not claim yourselves as pure or to be pure. So, or do not praise yourself, if you want to put it this way to be like clear, do not praise yourself. Does that make sense? Well, there's a different word for it, right? So do not praise yourself, basically. So, هو أعلم بمن اتقى. Allah knows who's best. Allah knows who's righteous. So the thing is, ولا تزكوا أنفسكم. Matter of fact, the person, as Muslims, we always think of, we should think of, like our shortcomings with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No matter how much do you do, you always think about, I could do more, I should do more. Think about your sins rather than counting your hasanat. Don't think about how many hasan you have done. Don't think I did this and this and that. Think about the bad deeds. So try to stop it, because the moment you think I'm doing so much and so good, you start praising, you're either going to be arrogant or you're going to make you do less when it comes to the deen. I think you need to open like this. So make you do less. So the thing is, Allah says, فَلَا تُزَكُّوا أَنفُسَكُمْ In all aspects, is not permissible. But Allah can do this. Allah can do this, but we cannot do it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَا يَسْتَوْ مِنْكُمْ مَنْ أَنفَقَ قَبْلِ الْفَتْحِ وَقَاتِلِ أُولَٰئِكَ أَعْظَمُ دَرَجَةً الَّذِينَ أَنفَقُوا بَعْدُ وَقَاتِلُوا So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, those people better than this people. The one who became Muslim before the conquest of Mecca, better than who after became Muslim after the conquest of Mecca. But however, they both are good, he said. Doesn't mean you criticize, so to be fair with the ayah. So both are good, but Allah said, those better. Allah could say that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had praised people in many occasions, like Sahaba, radiallahu anhum, wa radu anhum. Allah pleased with the companions, and they are pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah can do this, but we cannot, or we should not praise ourselves. So unless in certain ways are we allowed to praise ourselves, yes, sometimes we can. For example, do your resume. There's no way around it, right? So I did this and this and that. Or how about in the community, in the masjid, can you praise yourself? If Allah knows based upon your intention, Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, he said, اجعلني على خزائن, make me the treasurer. I'm good, I'm trustworthy. Because at that time they are in need for someone like Yusuf alayhi salam. If you come to the masjid or to the community or to your family or to your friends, things you could do and you know you're going to do a better job than the person who's doing, he said, try me out, I can do better inshallah. And Allah knows what you are conceiving. Are you doing this to be praised or give compliment from the people, or do you think you're saying this, I'm good at it because you want to help out and you know you are really good at it. See, the thing is, like a thin line between this, between being like stuck up or arrogant, and between the one who trying to help, and he see there's by telling people how much he knows, then will benefit the community and benefit the others. Make sense? Inshallah, this the thing is. So sometimes we have to do this to tell the people who we are. How about the others? There's something common between a lot of brothers and sisters, young and old. So males and females. The thing is here, a lot of times said, he is the greatest man. He is the best. You are allowed to do so, but there's rules to be followed. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw a man complimenting a person so much, praising him, this person, this and this, in his presence. Said, this guy, this and this, he was praising his friend. Said, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wayhak. Said, woe to you, you have broken the neck of your brother. So, in a way, you're praising the person too much in his presence, you make him, could be, get to him sometimes, he become arrogant. But what you say, Rasulullah said, if you want to praise someone, he said, أحسبه كذلك. I think he's this way. والله ولا أزكي الله. Allah knows best. I think he's great. I think he is good. I think so. He said, أحسبه كذلك. This is the Arabic word. So I think he's this way, and Allah knows best. So this will, ولا أزكي على الله أحدا. When you praise someone, always use this word, I think he is this way, and Allah knows best. And the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how did they praise themselves or themselves? They said, we are the children of Allah, and Allah loves us. And many occasions they who said, we are the chosen people. And definitely they were chosen at one point, but not anymore. But the thing is, here it said, we are the children of Allah, and Allah loves us, in one ayat. And he said this ayat, he said, لَن يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَ هُدًا أَوْ نَصَارًا. He said, no one will enter Jannah except you, if you are Jews or Christian. Allah said, قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ. Give me your proof. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, in different ayah, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have challenged, said, if you're saying this, you're going to go to Jannah, تَمَنَّوا الْمَوْتِ, wish to die then. If you guarantee Jannah, if someone tell you, Jannah 100% guarantee for you, what are you going to do in this dunya? There's no need. So he said, wish to die then, if you guarantee Jannah. So when the thing is here, the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, نَحْنُ أَبْنَاءُ, they praise themselves by saying, نَحْنُ أَبْنَاءُ اللَّهِ وَأَحْبَّاءُ. So we are the children of Allah, and Allah loves us. And they said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never torture us. And he said, بَلِ اللَّهُ يُزَكِّي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah, أذن فضل.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة لا إله إلا الله
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said here, I'm sorry, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بَلِلَّهُ يُزَكِّ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu purifies and prays him over he wants. Then he said, وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ نَقِيرًا. Oh, I'm sorry, وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ فَتِيلًا. وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ فَتِيلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nasir, there is no injustice when it comes to the judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah never unjust. Allah is the most just. One of his beautiful name, Al-Adl, the fair, the just. And he said in Hadith Qudsi, he said, إِنِّي حَرَّمْتُ الظُّلْمَ عَسِيَ. I made injustice haram for me, forbidden for me. And made it between you, among you, it's haram also. So, فَلَا تَظَالَمُ. Do not be unjust with one another. He said, وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ نَقِيرًا. They never, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being or will be unjust to them, even as much as فَتِيلَ. So fatila, the ayah says here, fatila mean that something Allah given us example from what we know, what the people back in the days know. Fatila, you know, the date seed, there's in the middle of the seed, there's something like a string. You can pull it out. Allah mentioned this. So this much, you'll never be dealt with injustice. So Allah shows here, Allah in different ayah said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَظْلِمُ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never unjust as much as the weight of Adam. So the thing is, Allah never unjust, whether small or big. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, big example for those people, things they know and they see this is the smallest thing to them back in the days. But even something smaller than that, Allah never unjust. Even the regular Adam, nowadays the nuclear, whatever, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never unjust with them, with the man. Then he said, انظر كيف يفترون على الله الكذب وكفى به إثما مبينا. Again, Allah tells Rasulullah, look how they lie about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And lying about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala big. Rasulullah lying about the Prophet himself huge. Said, if you lie about the Prophet intentionally, he said, the one who lied about me intentionally, let him be ready for the prepared place for him in hellfire. Let him be ready for the really prepared place for him in hellfire means lying about the Prophet ﷺ to say, well, Rasulullah ﷺ said this, halal. This is haram. This hadith, you shouldn't do that. Or you should do this. This is something we always have to understand. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran, this is something scary. Talk saying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, انظر كيف يفترون. يفترون type of liar. Look how they lie about Allah. يفترون type of lying, subhanAllah. وكفى به إثنان. This is sufficient as a sin for you when you lie about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a huge sin to say Allah have said this haram or this halal and you know this is haram. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the categories or the steps or the levels. To be more accurate, the level of haram. He said, قُلْ إِنَّمَا حَرَّمَ رَبِّيَ الْفَوَاحِشَ. Every evil act, immorality, مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمْبَطَنَ, everything, whether you've done it openly or secretly, وَالْبَغِي بِغِيَ الْحَقِّ. Then he said, the shirk, so level, after another level. And then he said, and to say about Allah without knowledge, as the worst sin a person can commit. Why lying about Allah so big? Anyone knows why? Seems like here Imam Qayyim Allah said this worse than shirk. Go ahead. No, it's, could be, but lying about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means you put yourself in a place for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this halal and haram. And only Allah can make halal and haram. So worse the shirk. Even the shirk had the biggest sin. But this is also huge. As the Imam said, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, this is the worst type. Because you're placing yourself in a position of who the one rules. Make this halal, make this haram. So be careful. Do not say this halal before you are sure. Do not say this haram before you make sure. Because when you say this haram, without you knowing it's haram, this is as you make him. You are the legislator, so you don't legislate things, make things right and wrong. So be careful with that. So under kafifun, wakafa bihi. This is sufficient as a sin for those the one who lie about Allah subhanahu wa taala. Then the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa taala said here again, ألم تر إلى الذين أوتوا نصيبا من الكتاب يؤمنون بالجبت والطاغوت ويقولون الذين كفروا هؤلاء أهدى من الذين آمنوا سبيلا. This little story beside behind this ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have you seen those people, the one who believe, people of book, the Jews, talk about two men mainly, two men, people of Ahl al-Kitab, Ka'b Ka'b al-Ahbar, Ka'b ibn Ashraf, wa Huyay ibn Akhtab, Allah knows best. So those people here, the two guys, Huyay ibn Akhtab and Ka'b ibn al-Ashraf, I'm sorry, Ka'b ibn al-Ashraf, and Huyay ibn al-Akhtab, those two men, they went to Quraysh right before the battle of the trench. And they told him, after they felt they won the battle of Uhud, said this is the time to gather all the Arabs together and the Jews and whatever around to terminate the Muslims from Medina. This is the time. This is what they thought. So they gathered every almost tribe around them to come and terminate the Muslims from the Medina and kill every one of them, subhanAllah. So they went there. They are people of the book. They should be different. They went to Mecca even though they know the Quraysh worship the idols. They used to criticize the Arabs at that time when they were worshipping idols. And they know they are wrong, but they still went there to ally with the Quraysh for one reason, because they hate the Prophet was not from them. Because the Prophet was Arab. So they don't want an Arabic Prophet, they want it from them. Even their Prophets, they did not believe in them, but still. So they went from Medina to Mecca to ally with the Quraysh, subhanAllah, for the reason is to gather together. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Utu nasiban min al-kitab." Allah said, those people know better. Just for animosity, for grudges, for hate, for jealousy, you want to go with the people who worship idols? SubhanAllah. يؤمنون بالجبت والطاغوت. So Quraysh, they asked him at that time, said, well, now you are people of scriptures. You know about divine books and you know right from wrong. Who do you think more right, us or Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Who do you think is more right, our deen or his deen? Then he said, no, it's you better. If his deen was better, we would follow him. We know. So they said, if you don't believe us, we're going to worship that. So they made some narration, said they made sujood to the idols. So to prove to them, that's their deen better than Islam. And they don't worship idols. But they did it for so because out of hate and jealousy, subhanAllah. And he said, even though the Quraysh said, us, Quraysh, we feed the Hujjaj, we provide water for them to drink and everything, residents. Back in the days, no hotels, nothing. This is they used to compete with one another. Who will have more Hujjaj at his house? They used to give you, go to Hajj, everything provided for free. There's no $10,000 back in the days. You just go to Hajj. You get your camel, your horse, and you're there. When you arrive there, you pay $0. Zero dinar, nothing. Everything provided by Quraysh, the Kuffar, subhanAllah. And this the competition between them. And that's why one of the reasons Abu Jahl did not want to become Muslim. Arrogance, of course, first. And then, because they said, we used to be like compete with Bani Hashim. They feed, we feed. Provide drink, we provide drink. Provide whatever homes, we provided home for the Hujjaj. Now they said, we have Prophet. So Bani Hashim, they said, we have Prophet, because Rasulullah is from the branch of Hashim. Said, how can we come up with a Prophet? So this is all jealousy and so on. He said, we give the food and we slaughter camels and animals to feed the Hujjaj. What this guy does, subhanAllah, of course, they made sujood to the Islam and they said, you have much better deen. As they, whatever it takes to terminate the Islam and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he said, يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْجِبْتِ وَالطَّاغُوتِ. Al-Jibt wa-Taghut, they said the Jibt, as they have different tafsir for the word Jibt, mainly the sihr, the magic. There is a jaha, magic, and Taghut, of course, idols or anything have been worshipped beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we say, no deity, no one worthy for Shabbat Allah. The word Tawud, remember, this word is mentioned a lot in the books of Tawheed and Aqeedah and so on. Tawud, anything have been worshipped beside Allah, including one's desire, including you follow a person blindly. So you follow one way blindly, this become a Tawud. So this Tawud, anything have been worshipped beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Come inside. Okay. Inshallah, finish it before on time today, inshallah. So then, وَيَقُولُونَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا هَؤُلَاءِ أَهْدَى مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا سَبِيلًا. And they say those are more guided and more right than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his ways. The asnam, the idols, worshiping those idols is more better way than the way for Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Allah said, أُولَئِكَ, those, الَّذِينَ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهِ. When you hear the word la'ana, Allah, la'an, literally translation means Allah have cursed, but means they are kicked out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those that have been kicked off the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mean the people of Ahl al-Kitab, the one who went to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the Quraysh, and they said, your way, O Quraysh, worship an idol, much better way than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Islam. Said, those are, have been kicked out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أولئك الذين لعنهم الله ومن يلعن الله. If Allah kicked someone out of his mercy, فلن تجد له نصيرا. Who's going to support him? Who's going to aid him? There's no way. No one can bring him back to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he was kicked or she was kicked off the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's no rahmah for them because they do not deserve it. So there's no one gonna be their allies, no one gonna help them, no one gonna aid them, and no one will be able to change the status or the position Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given.